In today's Diecast review, we're going to be taking a look at one of the coolest Chase Elliott paint schemes, and in my opinion, a very underrated one from 2020. Here is his Mountain Dew Chevrolet Camaro. Howdy, folks. It is Diecast Buffet here again. Welcome back to another NASCAR Diecast review, and today is might just be the final Mountain Dew Diecast ever produced in the NASCAR Cup Series. Wow, it is, Chase Elliott's 2020 Mountain Dew Chevrolet Camaro. I don't think there's any special naming to it. Yeah, it's just normal Mountain Dew Chevrolet Camaro. Now, this one's kind of interesting because if I recall, this car ran at, Dover, maybe, Michigan? One of those two races. He had three Mountain Dew paint schemes, right? You had the Mountain Dew Zero Sugar car. And then you had this one, and then you had the Team Rubicon or the Minecraft-looking one. And if you want to get any of those diecasts, hopefully they're in stock. It, you know, doesn't hurt to check. Link down below to Circle B Diecast and Plan B Sales. Use promo code DIECASTBUFFET, $20 or more. Guess what? You get free shipping. So, I mean, you get 3 164s right there. That's a $20 order. Guess what? Free shipping. Saves you $5 there. And then, to add on top of that, no tax. Save a crap load of money. I tell you what. You will save a lot compared to those stupid eBay scalpers. But anyways, folks, let's go and get this Chase Elliott Chevrolet Camaro right out of the box. Alrighty, folks, brand new out of that good old box. And my goodness, man, does the paint job on this car really stand out. Now, off camera, I would definitely say it is that traditional Mountain Dew green, kind of a light, I wouldn't say faded, but kind of a lighter lime green, right? But on camera, I mean, it looks borderline day glow. So that's a really cool shade of paint they use. Definitely got some reflection to it. And check out that silver metallic number right there on the roof. That is absolutely beautiful. The outline into the door numbers is absolutely fantastic. Now, in 2019, they had a metallic paint job for the Mountain Dew car. They had that. And in 2018, when he actually won Kansas, they had a metallic green paint job. This one is honestly just a normal gloss paint job. There's nothing too special to it besides the numbers. Now I understand they might have just changed the logos a little bit, you know, maybe changed the paint and all that stuff to kind of refresh the paint scheme, but I don't know. I have a theory about this, and I'm gonna get into that in a moment. So we got the Chevrolet Camaro stripes. Very cool stuff. It's going to be so different not seeing that the good old Mountain Dew paint scheme on track that is a sponsor that has been through NASCAR since Darrell Waltrip to, heck, Casey Kane, Jeremy Mayfield, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and now Chase Elliott. You got the number 9 right there. Hendrick Motorsports. You got ZL1. To me, this is detail right here. I love how the striping, the middle stripe, so to speak, kind of, it just a little bit of it is exposed right there above that bottom splitter. I like that detail right there. Very sharp. We got a freaking hair that's clear-coated or something there. I'm not too sure. Maybe a scratch. Got 3M and Sunoco. So my theory about this car, so I remember at the Dover race in 2020. It was a doubleheader weekend, right? Well, NASCAR had the teams do something really interesting. The cars were double wrapped. So let's say, for instance, this was the car that was going to run the Saturday Dover race. It had the Mountain Dew livery. Well, the car that was going to run on Sunday was Napa Auto Parts. They already paid for that sponsorship. They already had, you know, all their contracts, blah, 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 and ink. Well, anyways, I don't know how it really worked and how thick the paint jobs or whatever it is, but I just imagine that had some sort of difference in the performance, having two freaking car wraps on the same shell, that they could actually peel off the top layer and put the Mountain Dew or, you know, Chase whatever Napa Auto Parts stuff as the primary. They can just peel the top layer and have that bottom layer exposed. Now, I can't remember when this car ran. I think it ran at Michigan or Dover. I think it's one of those. But anyways, it could even be Pocono, to be honest with you. I think the reason why we don't see a metallic green is because this was a part of a doubleheader weekend in which they had to use decal wrap. They couldn't spray paint it metallic green, strip it down the metal, and then put the Napa livery, you know? That's my best theory. If you know more about it, feel free to comment down below. I would love to know the backstory, you know? So you got the NASCAR race car right here. Got an interesting paint chip. I'm not a big fan of that little A-pillar. Whatever you want to call it right there. I'm not a fan of that because it just kind of cuts off right there underneath the Chase Elliott logo. I'm not a fan of that. I got a paint chip right there. I got NASCAR race car, NASCAR Cup Series logo. That thing's kind of skewy. Got the Goodyear. Love the numbers, man. I mean, that it's actual silver, too. You know, very reminiscent of like a Day Glow stamping you would see on the Darlington throwback with Chase Elliott. Well, guess what? They used a special finish to get that kind of metallic-esque silver striping to it, which is really sharp. The B-Post decal has a very bad crease in the middle with the Exalta logo, Freightliner, Hooters, Mack Tools, Simeon's and Cincinnati Electric, Cali Blue Book, Valvoline. You got the, oh God, let's do a little bit of math here. So let's see. That should be the Charlotte Race Win logo, I think, because... Yeah, that would make sense, because this car was ran before the Daytona Road Course, which he got his second win of his first championship season, so this had to be the Charlotte Race Win stickers. Got the Chase Elliott logo right there, Georgia flag, got Mountain Dew right there, Napa Auto Parts, Universe, and Hooters. The paint scheme design is very sharp, just a normal, it's almost Day Glow. It really is a reflective green. Off camera, it's not Day Glow by any means, but on camera, it's definitely got that additive to the paint to really reflect on a digital lens. Really sharp stuff. You have your vintage late 60s, early 70s muscle car stripes and a little bit of a side gradient, a little bit of a stripe that kind of etches out to the back wind or the back wheels. Going over to the back of the car here, you got, well, this is something Dale Jr. made very popular, is having the whole back end of the car just painted black, which I personally love. I think it's a very sharp way and kind of modern as well. I just love how the stripes are, you know, they kind of start at the trunk line where the spoiler is, painted black as well. It just goes across the dome and it goes across to the nose. Very, very sharp. Got the Mountain Dew logo there. I like how that red really pops out with that black background there. Very sharp. I wish so badly they would have either made a code red Mountain Dew Chase Elliott car, or they would have made a pitch black 2 Chase Elliott car, because you bet your bottom dollar, man. If they took the paint scheme they used on Jeremy Mayfield's Dodge Charger back in 2005, slapped it on a Camaro for 2021 or 2020, my goodness, you might be talking about diecast of the year. Got the number 9 right there, very screwed up Camaro logo, ZL1-1LE. Go over to the right side of this diecast and just, I don't know what's going on with that Mountain Dew logo, but I tell you what, it's not doing the do. Something's a little off right there. Maybe it's just the body angles, but I don't know. Something just doesn't look right to me there. I cannot get over that freaking silver. Like, that silver is just absolutely beautiful. And while this might not be the most flashy paint scheme you'll see, there's just something about this car that I really like. I mean, it's a very reflective green. Like I said, it's not a safety yellow, safety green where it reflects in sunlight or anything like that, but it definitely has a change of temperature once you get it on the digital lens. I love that red though, the black and then the green. It's just a very nice combination with that little bit of a darker green right there in the Mountain Dew logo. Over here to the dome of the diecast, got the Cup Series logo right there, got your bow ties, you got the beautiful silver, and I'm just going to give you a little bit of a closer look and what to expect when you get this diecast in your hands. I mean, check this out. Look at that beautiful silver gradient right there, my dude. That is sharp. That is beautiful, especially with that three-dimensional imprint with that roof flap. Very sharp stuff. Got both of the stripes to go across the roof. Got Mountain Dew right there. Chase Elliott and Napa Auto Parts right there on the deck lid. I gotta say, folks, this is a underrated Chase Elliott paint scheme. Now, is it better than the 2018 one? Well, the diecast quality, maybe, because it's got the roof... but you got the front and back windshield banners. But I will say, though, the paint quality, I much prefer the metallic green, because I love pearlescent, I love metallic, I love matte finishes. I just love when people play with a paint job, you know what I'm saying? I will say, though, this is a surprise. I kind of tiptoed in this thinking, okay, this is just going to be a normal paint scheme. But the difference between the diecast you hold in your hands, which I will say, it is a normal Mountain Dew green, that light lime green. But when you get it on the digital lens, it is much more reflective. And I think the reason they did that is because they wanted this paint scheme to pop on the television lens. So I applaud Mountain Dew and Hendrick Motorsports and Exalta Coatings coming up with this paint job. Very nice stuff. A very underrated Chase Elliott paint scheme from his championship season. Thank y'all so much for watching the video. Make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Like, come and subscribe. And if you want to get this diecast or any 2021s, heck, 124s, race wins, freaking hats, merchandise, whatever you want, and you want to save a crap load of money. I mean, think about it. You get a 124, you're going to save $10 with this free shipping code right here. Diecast Buffet. You know what you could do with $10? That's two extra Authentics diecast, a bag of beef jerky, three boxes of cereal. It doesn't freaking matter. It's incredible stuff. That's how I get all my 124s, 164s, you name it. So it's a great way to save a lot and, you know, get those cool merchandise gear for your favorite driver. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. Hope you're having a great one. Like, comment, and subscribe. Diecast Buffet, signing off. Also, check out that back well, though. Holy moly.